you can't be in this world without having some understanding about how precarious it is.
Unprecedented fires
raging out of control.
I was in Sydney, Rachel rang to say, I don't think the farm will be here tomorrow morning.
Fortunately, we were spared. But what about next time? What about the future our grandchildren will inherit? Then my farm manager, Mick, shared a revelation.
Agriculture is causing climate change, not just fossil fuels.
I was shocked to learn we were part of the problem.
What are we looking at?
Soil moisture, or the lack of it.
It's pretty dead, doesn't
it? Dry, dead.
Regenerative farming is not to harm your land.
You're burying carbon rather than releasing it.
That is it.
The shift to regenes to combat climate change.
And that is what I'm going to commit every part of my being to. Driving up
the coast. We learnt about totally different grazing management. No insecticides, no herbicides, some biofertilizer, and making my own compost. So much goes wrong.
It didn't look good for a while, but still I felt this driving urgency to show this type of farming could work. But it wasn't long before we were in the middle of another huge climate crisis.
Was it hard? Very hard.
After the floods receded, we saw the immense amount of work that was ahead of us. But that was nothing to what was to come.
Nature's never about one thing. It's about a multitude of relationships.
Every animal is a vein to the main root of this earth.
When you get things in balance, nature wakes up and starts to build on herself.
Oh my God, a whole family of them.
That just blows my mind.
Regen farming allows a more active role for women. It's not as reliant on brute strength.
Oh, that looks fun.
I feel incredibly hopeful.
Just stand at the doorway.
I know that changing my farm is not going to change the world, but if everybody does a little bit, we can.
Are they coming? Yeah.
Come on!